hear people speaking any language, hear them very carefully. If you hear the person speaking, he must be using certain words which may have some, what we can say, relation with what he speaks, and certain words may not have any kind of relation with what he speaks. Then why do that person speak those words? What are these words? Suppose matlab, samjhe, dekha, kya hua ki. We use these kind of words, these kind of phrases in Hindi too, many times. Not only in Hindi, in every language, almost in every language, this kind of words are there which do not have any meaning over there. But what they do is they give the connectivity into the, bring about the connectivity into the language. What is this connectivity? Already it has been told many times that a good language has a good fluency. The language is such or that which has very good fluency. It should flow, should not stop anywhere. If at all it has stopped, we can understand there is something wrong with it. Suppose a person is not walking, means something wrong with him. If the vehicle is not moving, something wrong. Likewise, the language, it is not moving forward, means there is something wrong. And hence, there are certain words created. There are certain words created to keep this fluency in the language, the flow in the language. Such kind of words, they may not have any kind of meaning or usage. We may use it, we may not use it. Without that usage also, we are getting the meaning. But sometimes we use it. That using of those words, that is called connectors, because it connects to this sentence, to this sentence, this clause to this clause, this word to this word. That way we use Rama and Sita, and word we have put over there. Rama, Sita, we did not say. Rama and Sita. Rama kicked the ball and made a goal. Rama kicked a ball. One sentence. Rama made a goal. One more sentence. And was not at all necessary over there. But we can combine these two, putting that and. Continuity, flow is there. I am not splitting this sentence and this sentence. I am keeping a flow. So the words which keep the flow of the language are which connect two sentences, two or more sentences, or two or more phrases, two or more clauses, two or more words, those are called as connectors. Right? So these connectors, are there any fixed words for that? Are there any fixed words for this connection purpose? That we are going to see in this chapter, unit 6, connectors. So before going to the word connector, let us see how the word has come. So the word connect, it is the verb connected, connected, connecting, to connect. Because it has taken ed to form its past tense, it is a regular verb. So to it, if at all we are adding ion, it becomes connection. Yeah, you can see connection. Whenever we are adding ion or tion or ssion, right, that becomes a noun. So this is the verb and this is the noun. Why I am telling this is, in our next chapter we have that. Nominality, something is there. How to form the noun form from the verb. How to form the noun form from the adjectives. We have it. So let us have start from here. Connect, connection. So if this is a noun, what is the connector? connection means the relation between these two, with which the action, name of the action is connection. Name given to the action is connection. Then what is this connector? And also we have put an S over there. Means what? It has to be a plural. If at all it is a plural, it has to be a noun. So what is that noun again? Connector, one who, what, that which. One who connects is the connector. One which it connects, it is the connection. Sorry, connector. Right? The plug is there. In that we are putting this plug pin. Those two are connected to each other. Right? And I am connecting this person and that person. So I am the connector. So middleman, we can say. Right? And that middle gives a flow to the language, and so it is called as connectors. Right? After having known what is connectors and what are these connectors, into how many groups we can have them, read them, understand them, and which connector used to be used in which place. Right? This is what we are going to learn now. If we learn very carefully about this, there are certain passages, there are certain exercises over there that becomes very easy for us to fill in. Right? So let us see the types of connectors. So what we have talked here about is connectors. Has it any other name? Yeah, it has. Conjunction. Conjunction. Right? And those which unites. Conjunction. It unites. Unites this one and this one. That is called, again, conjunction. When I say conjunction, you have clearly understood. There are conjunctions, yes sir. But where to use them? Can we use any conjunction and the same conjunction there? No. Why? Because they have a certain purpose. Though they connect it, but they have certain purpose over there. For simple example, which you can clearly understand. And wherever we can use and, can we use but over there? Just let us see. And, but, or, yet. These four we count as conjunctions. And, but, or, yet. We call them as conjunctions. Very good. Can we use the in the place of and, can we use or? No. In the place of but, can we use or? No. In the place of but, can we use yet? No. They have their specific purpose and specific place where they can be used. Now, we are connecting these two. There we are using and, but, or, yet. While connecting itself, there is some difference. That is, I had been to market yesterday and I had purchased, there I have used and. Means positive action, and I am putting and between. What is the positive action? Going to market and purchasing something. These two are the positive actions, and there I am putting and. So I had been to market yesterday. I had purchased 1 kilo of apples. Let us think that. Suppose I use but over there. I had been to market, but I purchased 1 kilo. Can it be? No. Certainly it is wrong. Means what we learned now with this example is the connectors are there. They may be useless. Without them also we can make out the meaning. And so I said useless. But they are not entirely useless. They are very useful. Where? where we use them in an appropriate manner. Wherever we use them in an appropriate manner, these connectors are very, what we can say, very beautifully we have used them. As I said, and. Rama but Sita, we don't use Rama and Sita. Rama but Sita are wife and husband and wife. Can we say like that? No. Rama and Sita are husband and wife. Again, Rama and Sita are husband but wife. No. Definitely you'll say it is wrong. So where we are using and, two positive things and two things which are to be added positively, then where is the but? I had been to market yesterday but could not purchase anything. Here it is negative, here it is positive. Here it is negative, here it is positive. That way we are using them. Did you see it or not? Both are positive, so we are using and, both are negative, we are using and. One is positive, the other is negative, we are using but. Right? Rama and Bharat, these are neighbors, but they are enemies.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.